Hello viewers, welcome to the channel. In this video, we are going to perform proof of concept for gaining initial access using Windows shortcut lnk file. Before we start our demonstration, let's try to understand how emoted and quantum APT groups are using Windows shortcut file to gain initial access. We noticed a threat actor functioning for 8 days in June 2022 after acquiring access to an environment through emoted. Cobalt Strike was used during this time for numerous rounds of enumeration and lateral movement. Tactical RMM and AnyDesk were two examples of remote access tools that were used for command and control. The threat actor's last operations included the domain-wide deployment of quantum ransomware and data exfiltration using clone. Similar characteristics were seen in earlier situations involving emoted and quantum. When a user double-clicked an lnk file, encoded PowerShell commands were run, which downloaded an emoted DLL into the computer. Emoted created a registry run key after it was run in order to keep persistence on the beachhead host. Then, emoted went on to run a brief list of discover commands using the Windows tool systeminfo, ipconfig, and notice that were directed at the domain controllers on the network. The emoted process would continue to run these commands every day. After being executed for around an hour and a half, emoted started sending spam emails with fresh malicious attachments. Similar behavior persisted through the second day of the incident. But on the third day, emoted delivered an executable beacon for Cobalt Strike onto the host of the beachhead. The threat actors initiated a new round of discovery operations using the Cobalt Strike beacon. They ran Windows NIC commands that targeted domain groups and computers, ran noticed once more, then used tasklist and ping to look at a distant host. Later, the threat actor walked lateral to a desk. The script was executed on the remote host, but it didn't appear to be able to connect to the command and control server when they initially tried to perform this activity using a PowerShell beacon and a remote service on the host. The executable for a beacon was then transferred via SMB to the remote host's program data directory. The WMI command to execute this beacon was then successful, as was the connection to the threat actor's server. Now the time for demonstration, let's get started. We hope you enjoyed this proof of concept PUC video. Thank you for watching. Please support the videos by liking, subscribing, and sharing them.